Hey everyone, how are you doing? Mike here, and today we're going to take a look at the Spider Farmer series. We have the SF1000, the 2000, and the 4000. And in this video, we're going to cover everything from PAR. We're going to cover the how hot she runs. We're going to cover the electrical current being pulled from the wall. We're basically going to cover it all in this video, and we found a couple of interesting things about this light that I bet that a few of you guys probably haven't seen or noticed before. So we're just going to point out some of the differences that we see here from the older series lights that came out in January, and this is in July, and there's actually some pretty big changes to these lights, so we're gonna cover them all in this video. Now, the LEDs, nothing has really changed with the LEDs. We're still using the Samsung LM301Bs. I can't say which the other LEDs are, the deep red or in the IR, still don't know what those are. The company does say that they are Samsung, but we don't really know. So they are still using a meanwell driver, XLGs, and these are using the ELGs, sorry. The ELGs, one's using a 240 and the other one is using a minute. I'll put the correct one down below. So one of the first things that I noticed right away, as soon as I opened it up, was looking at the new lights. There is quite a bit of a difference between the gel coating currently than what there was before. Now, I have the light here before, and there is a very thick coating of this gel over top of it. It's actually so thick that if you take a microscope to it, you can't even really see the details of the LED. So you're seeing that here. And if we take a look at the SF1000, the current version of the light, there's a very, very, very thin, you can see full details of the LED. And that makes a difference, actually. It's going to give you about a 2 or 3% increase in PAR. So another thing that they have added is this controller box with a dimmer on it. It pretty much speaks for itself. So with this dimmer box, it uses a RJ45 telephone line. And this basically connects to a other light. I'm just gonna give you a little demonstration here. And so now I can control this light from this light. Some may think that's really cool. Personally, I'm gonna say I'm not too impressed by this feature just because I've seen how much it increased the price of the light. So I don't want this to take away from the light because the lights are actually really good. When we take a look at the PAR results, they're pretty impressive. So we're gonna get into that here in a couple of moments. We're gonna do, like I said, we're gonna do the heat. We're going to check the wattage draw, and we're gonna show you all the PAR results. So let's get into it. Guys, so let's take a look at the data. I think the data usually speaks for itself here. So we, as you can see here, we did it in a 2x2 tent. Our watts was pulling was 99 watts from the SF1000. The driver temp was 55 degrees Celsius. The bottom was 56 degrees Celsius, and the top was 53. So it's pretty warm. Considering some of the other lights that we have tested were a little bit cooler than that. So this is up there, but not terrible. So let's take a look at the average PPFD, 474 at the 12, 437 at the 14, and 369 at 18 inches. The highest that we got out of it was 1.7. So like I said, not terrible, not overly powerful, but we've already tested the SF1000, so we kind of knew this before. So let's take a look at the SF2000 now. So here we go. Let's just try to make this into a size that we can see this here. So a little bit better with the SF2000. So what I'm going to do here is, we'll go over the driver temp. 61 degrees Celsius, we're getting pretty warm there. Bottom of the board, 50 degrees, and top of the board, 60. So once again, this is 60s. That's really warm. That's the highest temperature on top board that I believe that we've got off of a light. So taking a look at the actual PAR maps, not terrible. These are actually pretty good. And what I've noticed is the more that we go up in these lights, the larger light, the lot better the results that we're getting, right? Obviously. So you can see here in the corner, 200, 268, 250, 348. These aren't that bad results. Looking under the light at 12 inches, 1100, or you can definitely grow some nice butt out of that. 16 inches, the same, 800. That's still pretty good numbers. Then we're going to take a look at the 18 inch and 24 inch. And basically all the numbers that you really guys are looking for here. So like I said, a lot of data on these lights. So lastly, let's take a look at the SF4000. So this was done in a 4x4. Driver, 61 degrees, bottom, 53 degrees, top, 60. I was actually jumping between 60 and 61. It was very warm. I think that what I would like to see is if they put a heat sink on this light, some sort of heat sink, anything better than what they had now, because it is working, but it's definitely not the coolest running lights out there, just because they're only using this thin aluminum plate as a heat sink. So anyways, let's take a closer look down here at the PAR results. So we can see this light here is insane. 12 inches, this is not practical. You wouldn't be put this under 12 inches even with CO2. 18 inches is still up there, 1300 micromoles under the center of the light. That's pretty big. That's a pretty high number, guys. 22 inches and 24. This SF4000 really impresses me. I'm gonna say that this is a nice light. You could hang this thing at like 24, 26 inches and get away with it. You know what I mean? That's a pretty decent light. And one light for your whole grow tent would be just great. Even at the $800 mark, that's a fair price for this light. I just think it could be a little cheaper if we got rid of this box or whatever. But anyways, it is what it is. So all in all, guys, these are some pretty good numbers. And I'm pretty impressed by the larger lights. The smaller one, but the larger lights are pretty good. Yeah, I would like to thank everybody for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hope this was able to help you out, give you some information to go by. And you guys all have yourself a great day. Thank you all for watching.